lineup for you today, but let's start with a quick look at the latest project for the boys at HBF. And by the way, if this seems like an unlikely place to experience raw horsepower, you might want to hang around.
All right, well, look, this is the Hilux, otherwise known as the Lolux. They're called the Lolux because it's had all the lowering kit put into it, so it'll, you know, sit on its chassis, basically. It was delivered here from Toyota, so the customer bought it. Got it delivered here. We stripped it entirely, you know, left basically just a bare engine in it, and started with the twin turbo kit. Look, if you can see, you know, made the manifolds, and a lot of the hardware's been made, you know, to house the turbos. Still in the process of tweaking and modifying. Made a new plenum and intake manifold for it. Inner cooler and radiator, which I have here, are pretty well done. You know, I've had to make new fan shroud, modify all the thermostat housings and everything so that the, you know, everything flows the way we want it to. If you have a look in front, we've got the trans cooler and oil cooler incorporated in one, which are all fit neatly behind the bar without modifying chassis or, you know, or modifying as few of the components as possible. Not that it really matters if you look at the scale of the project.
I've been walking for hours. How on earth does Rob think he's going to get me down from here?
Has anyone seen Rob? His wife's on the phone.
I suppose one of the things that the Horsepower Factory like to do is keep up with all the latest model cars and offer our customers the latest packages. Toyota were kind enough to loan us this new TRD Hilux 4000SL. It has a number of differences inside. It's got black leather trim seats with the TRD logo, TRD steering wheel. Individually numbered cars, so they have a plaque inside and one under the engine bay. Outside of the car, it's pretty cool. It's got TRD body kit on it, a bit more aggressive in its styling. It's got, which definitely you notice on the ride, it's got Bilstein shocks, 17-inch alloy wheels. They've improved the braking, which is kind of cool, because quite often they'll, you know, do upgrades to the engine and not do anything to the brakes, but in this case, they've seen fit to put four-piston calipers on the front. Under the bonnet, it's got the 4-litre V6. This time in this model, the TRD, they fitted the M90 supercharger, which was basically developed in conjunction with Magnuson products in the US. That's given the car, obviously, a 25% increase in torque. And you definitely notice that on the road. The interesting thing with this engine is that it actually is more fuel efficient than the naturally aspirated V6 and produces more torque from just above idle right through to 5700. So I'm going to get Marty on the job and see what he can find and give me a bit of feedback so we can start to put together some packages for our customers.
Take my money. Rob's decided to get the boys out of the factory to learn a bit about air suspension. Pimped.
Oh, she's a gold digger. Way over town. That digs on me. She give me money.
Now I ain't saying she a gold digger. I've been seeing a lot of these Chinese or lesser quality airbags on the internet lately. I mean, what's the difference between what you guys sell and what I'm seeing on the internet?
Well, basically, we've got two half cuts here of two bags that have both come out of vehicles. This first bag is what you refer to and seen on the internet. Now you can see this bag obviously can barely even support its own weight.
Yeah, right.
Now, if you can imagine, that's your suspension, and you're relying on this solely to hold your vehicle up. Then, you know, at the end of the day, which one are you going to be choosing?
Yeah.
We run with this bag because it actually doesn't balloon over its entire, like the entirety of its travel.
Yeah, see, this has got like some wire reinforcement there. The other bag doesn't have any of that sort of...
No, these bags have got a billet top. Yep. Which is laminated and also has rods through it.
Okay.
That actually holds it all together.
Yep.
So to prevent that ballooning action.
Right.
with these, they're also a lot thinner. And okay. the lamination here's only got like a string cord through it,
okay.
as opposed to the wire reinforcement that these ones have got.
Things like where the air fittings go in and things like that, is that an issue, like with threads pulling out?
Absolutely. You can see on the internal of this that there's, you know, not a lot of material holding through there. With the lamination in these and the depth of the bolt hold, you're actually able to get a far better purchase on any bolt that's going to be going into there.
Yeah.
With the air fittings, they're also a lot firmer. Yeah. Being billet tops and billet bottom also makes for a better quality.
So I guess what you're saying is you pay for what you get.
At the end of the day, that's yeah. really what we try to promote.
And is there a big difference in price, like realistically?
Realistically, for as far as safety goes, like for an extra 20, 30 bucks, you can have a far better ride quality and a far yeah. superior product.
Yeah, no, well, it makes sense.
It's really not worth the compromise yeah. at the end of the day. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger,
but she ain't messing with no broke niggas. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger. Hey, you're Bruce. Mate, what are you doing with my glove?
I like your glove. So I'm sure plenty of people have liked your glove.
Yes, they have. We won't go into detail.
No, definitely not. What are you up to, mate?
I'm just working on this Watts-Link kit.
Good stuff.
Universal kit. Nice. We use it in the vehicle you're working on, actually, the O7 Hilux.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's the same for all, is it? Or
yeah, virtually the same. Sometimes we modify the length of the arms, but the kit itself, the centre pivot and both the mounts and all the bushes are the same.
Okay, good stuff. So that's the end mounts?
Yep. Chassis mounts, fairly universal fit.
So it's all Nolathane?
Yeah, Nolathane bushes, grade 8 bolts, crush tubes. And it's all, the parts that don't get modified are all painted, ready to go when we send them out.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Nice and easy to fit.
Yeah, it's a neat kit, seems to work well.
Got plenty of projects going on.
Absolutely, graveyard down the back there. Yeah. You ever had a look around?
Briefly, but yeah, I like the old Volksy.
The single cab split screen combi, it's pretty rare rig. Oh,
definitely.
No, plenty going on.
Needs a bit of work, it seems.
Yeah, I reckon.
Someone going to sit on the ground too?
Yeah, probably. Like most things. That one's actually been dragged out of a paddock up in New South Wales and it's going to get a full resto and airbag suspension fitted.
No, good stuff.
Yeah.
I have to come down and have a look when it's going on.
Yeah, that'd be great. Come and have a look and harass Chad, show him how to build a real engine.
Hey, Georgie, check out my new ride, mate. Do you want to go for
Unreal.
A cruise?
No. You're
sure?
On your own, Rob.
You're soft.
I don't hear words they're saying.
Say what, sucker?
Only the echoes of my mind. People stopping still. I can't see their faces.
After the break, a closer look at the TRD. And Rob has Marty a little nervous. Now let's see how George is going on the Lolux project while I wait for Rob and Marty to get me off this mountain.
So realistically, I mean, where are we at the moment? Because we've got to get it to paint.
I've yet to do the, as far as, you know, got to work out how we're going to get that halfway through, but I'd say a month. Me finishing, then Marty taking over and wiring and stuff.
You haven't got a month. How's Marty going with the Motec and wiring?
Oh, look, if you ask me, I don't think he's getting anywhere because it looks like a big mess in there, but I think he's making progress.
You got 2 weeks.
I'm on holiday soon.
No, you're not.
No, you're right.
You're not allowed holidays. When you spoke to Reese, did he talk about the lower steering knuckles?
He did. He's actually, I think he's coming back tomorrow.
Yeah. And you say Shaw City.
City. I'm coming home again. Look, Chad and Reese from DW Customs just arrived. Going to run you through all the suspension. I've got to get back on the front because Rob's cracking the whip. So, here's Chad and Reese.
Basically, what we started with was a 2007 Hilux. We've had to redesign and reconfigure a number of parts on the vehicle to basically make it sit flat on the ground. The chassis sections were designed based on the fact that the diff has to come up probably about 10 inches in order for the vehicle to lay flat on the ground. We've obviously designed a chassis notch. The notch is about 12 inches in diameter, in height, so we can obtain that extra clearance that was necessary in order to make the vehicle lay flat. Reese is going to run you through some of the suspension components, and he'll take you through all the airbag parts of it.
So once we'd finished the notch, we went on to building the suspension components. Where possible, we used suspension components such as the control arms out of factory vehicles. So the lower arms in this particular one are from a Land Cruiser 80 series, and the uppers are from a Pajero. The reason for that is they're easier to engineer. They've already been factory tested. In the case of the lower arms, we have made a slight modification. We've added a spring plate and a gusset for strength underneath. Because the system's a cantilever system, where the spring is actually on the lower arm instead of on the differential, by having a cantilever system, you're allowing yourself to have more travel, suspension travel, and a better ride quality. You can run lower pressures and also get more lift out of the vehicle. In the rear, behind the diff, we've used a lateral locator called a Watts link, and we weren't able to come up with factory components, so we fabricated our own. We used cold drawn seamless steel and nolathane bushes in this case, and because they were fabricated, we had to have some testing done. The rest of the system is pretty simple in the fact that it's similar to any other air suspension system. You've got two electric compressors, two air reservoirs, and all the componentry to make it function. We have the valves underneath, and then all the electrical system, including the self-leveling, to help with engineering. The shock absorbers were relocated so that we could maintain as much travel as possible. We used the original factory shock absorbers, just repositioned them so that they were as vertical as possible to allow for the least amount of axle torque and axle tramp in the case that this vehicle is going to have some power through it. Right, so over here we've got the vehicle's space cab tub. Being a space cab, we've got plenty of room to fit wheel tubs to accommodate the large wheels. These wheel tubs were fabricated out of 1.6 sheet, and they accommodate the 22-inch wheels, and they've also been brought in to fit the narrow diff. The notch cover is basically a modification to the floor that we've had to do to accommodate the notching of the chassis and also the relocation of the two shock absorbers. In the front here, we've got two little notches just for the upper arms, and we've put it in primer ready for paint when it goes to the paint shop.
Hey George, we'll catch you later, mate.
No worries, mate. Take it easy.
Good to see you.
Be good.
George.
Enjoy. See you in a couple of weeks, yeah, when this is done.
Okay, what we've got here is the new TRD Hilux 225 kilowatt supercharged V6. It's got the Eaton M90 supercharger, basically the same as on the V6 Commodore that people have been playing with for many years now, and it's making 146 kilowatts on our dyno, which is working out to about the 225 claimed power that they rated at. And it's running about £6 a boost. We believe you could quite simply put a smaller pulley on the blower and give it a couple more pound a boost. We're just looking at the intake now and saying our steps down here, we're going to try maybe pull that off and give it another run, see how much power is actually just in that small modification. Okay, we've just pulled the air filter and intake off, and we've picked up 10 kilowatts just by doing that. The boost's gone up slightly because it's got the less intake restriction. Superchargers don't like intake restrictions, so you free up the intake, you'll pick up more boost. It also leaned out the mixtures a bit because the airflow meter's here, and because it didn't have the restriction in front of it, it actually showed different airflow going into the engine and went a bit leaner. What I'm going to do now is just remove this and put this section back on and see whether the power pickup is in the whole box or just in that. We'll give that a go. Eight of the 10 kilowatts was found in the factory air filter element. As you can see, it's quite a thick element designed obviously to be the maximum filtration. Fit in an aftermarket unit such as a K&N or something, which is an oil type filter, is much thinner and will be much freer flowing, gaining most of that 8 kilowatts back. Okay, I think we're done here. I've got to put this thing back together now and get it back to Toyota. They only loaned it to us for a few hours. I think it's going to be a perfect candidate for some easy power upgrades.
I think I've got enough information now from what I've seen and done to start putting together some power packages.
You're struggling a bit there, Marty.
I'll get it. It's
you need right. A hand, mate.
No, I've got it, thanks.
You sure?
Yes.
Gee. How do we go, mate?
Yeah, good. Picked up 10 kilowatts, just taking the lid off.
Okay, yeah, the airbox looks like a bit of a unique design.
Yeah, most of the restriction was actually in the element.
Okay. I'll tell you what, I got a perfect little spot up at Jimbrook, mate, that we'll just go and see what it's really capable of doing.
No, you can't do that. Toyota have given it to us in good faith.
4:30, mate. I'll be out the front. Meet me there, and we'll go and give it a bit of a workout. Don't be a girl. I got the blouse in the car for you, mate. I'll pull it out.
Get your hand off me ass.
When we return, I get back on the tools and Rob and Marty get down and dirty. Now today, Ian's going to show me how to put a bit of spark under my bonnet. Right now, where do I start?
Okay, here we go. We're going to put the coil on first,
Joe.
Righty tighty. Now see if you can pull that bolt out. Get the bolt, yeah. Now pull the coil out. Okay, and now we're going to pull the spark plug out. Sock it down on that spark plug all the way down. And lefty loosey again.
Lefty loosey.
Now you've got to push this down.
Like
once
this?
You've got it loose, yeah, we'll pull the ratchet off and undo that.
Like so?
Yes, yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Keep going, push it. Yeah, you haven't pulled it out yet. Keep going.
Trying.
That should be enough. Spark plug there. No.
How do I get in there?
Okay. No, she's still mouthing at the spark plug.
Okay.
And that's your spark plug.
And then what do you do?
Well, actually, we'd look at the spark plug to see if it's all right. Whether it's worn out or it's dirty.
And how can you tell?
It's usually a mileage sort of thing, so at a certain kilometres you'll replace them, but you'll check the colour, make sure it's burning all right. It could be fouled with oil, carbon deposits, and it could be worn out on the tip. So that's pretty worn and tied, it's a bit dirty. So we put a new one in, which looks like that. Nice and clean. We have to check the gap in it and then put it back in. Lefty loosey, righty tighty.
Let's do it.
So put it in the hole, we've checked the gap, tighten it up.
And righty tighty.
Yep. Which needs it stopped. Now we've got to put the tension, the ratchet on there. Now hang it to that and pull down on here. Pull that nice and straight.
Oh,
straight.
We'll tight like
yep.
That.
And pull down. So up again.
Like this?
Yep. That's it.
Okay, that's tight.
That's it. I'll just check it to make sure you're right because we've got to crush that washer. That's not bad. And we put the coil back on. You'll line that hole up when she goes in with the bolt.
Like so?
Yep. And then that, push that coil right down.
See you later.
Tighten that up. And then span it back on. Nope. Like this. Yep, that's it. Yes, got it.
Oh,
righty
yeah.
Tight. That's it. And that's how the coil and the spark plugs are replaced.
Thank you. We've just changed it. So fantastic.
Come on, baby. Struggling with that there, Rob?
Not at all, Marty.
Sharpen that drill bit yourself?
No, I found it in that drawer of blunt drills over there.
I think that girl's blouse is for you, not for me.
Mate, you just make sure you bring your iron jocks for our four-wheel drive expedition later on today.
All right, you want me to help you give you a pull on this?
Is that my arse you're grabbing?
No.
Haven't I showed you how to sharpen the drill before?
Yeah, but...
Well, with this particular drill here, it won't possibly drill a hole because the leading edge is lower than the trailing edge. Therefore, it's rubbing on the back of the drill instead of the front of the drill. And also, on looking at it on the end of the drill, it's not a chisel shape, it's more of a centre punch.
Yeah, okay. So is the angle of the drill face?
Yeah, I think it's 105 degrees. I say it does vary according to what material you're using.
Okay, so this drill that I was trying to drill with before, you reckon you could just sharpen that for me just so I can see how you do it on the corner?
Yeah, no problem.
No worries.
Done. You've got the leading edge now where it does the cutting, and you've got the chisel in and the front of the drill on the end of the drill.
All right, well I better go and finish drilling that hole.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that, it's like Swiss cheese. You're a legend. Hey, hey, before you go, I've got a few drills for you to sharpen.
Oh, you got to be joking, haven't you?
Well, you know, last time I looked, we were paying you at least a cup of coffee a drill, so I reckon that's about a year's worth of coffee.
Well, it looks like my ride's arrived. We hope you've enjoyed this week's episode. I'm your host, Joe, and you've been watching... Ride!